Good afternoon or good evening, friends. Again, Selvakumar here. So today we have a very short session to discuss about a precise question, why high capacity generators are not solved yet. This is what we are going to see. Different generators and their configurations, earth fault detection in low voltage and medium voltage, and we are going to address why HV generators are not solidly earth. So that's the topic which we are going to address. So let's talk about generators and its configurations, and I'm not sure whether this image is clear or not. So if it is not clear, then probably we can go to ETAB. This is could be a typical diesel generator configuration. So you have 11 kV grid where the commercial building or industry is getting power supply from, and that is stepped down to 415 volt, and that is feeding quite a lot of outgoing feeders. And there is a standby diesel generator which is kept out of service when the grid is available, and when the grid fails for whatever may be the reasons, then this diesel generator will come into picture and it will feed the loads. Now, so when the system is operating in a normal mode, you may aware this transformer winding configuration is delta on the 11 kV side and the star grounded solidly earth system on the 415 volt. Why this generator on the LV side is star? That's a simple reason. We might be having a single phase loads at the LV side, so it has to be star, and it should be solidly earth. Why it should be solidly earth? Most of the time, the LV system, the protection devices are of air circuit breakers, molded case circuit breakers, MCBs, that is miniature circuit breakers, fuses. So, means except electronic release, all other protections like thermal magnetic or MCBs, this doesn't have any special detection mechanisms for the earth fault. Okay, so generally this is LV system is solidly earthed, so that the fault current could be higher and the fault can be identified by the current principle. So if you take a thermal magnetic release, which we might be discussing, right? I have taken an example of molded case circuit breaker. The molded case circuit breaker can either come up with a thermal magnetic release, or it can be of an electronic or a solid state, whatever you call. So I have considered here thermal magnetic. In thermal magnetic, I mean, so to say, thermal is for meant for overload protection and magnetic is for a short circuit protection. So if there is a single line to ground fault, I mean, so to say, that will be detected by phase principle only, in the sense only your thermal relay or magnetic detection mechanism has to pick up and detect the fault if it is a thermal magnetic relay. Otherwise, you need to add an additional earth fault relay to sense if you want to detect it at much lesser current. Mean, if you are going with a 500 amps MCCB and if you want to set it at 100, you cannot detect any earth fault current less than 500 amps. Assume there is a single line to ground fault in the LV system with maybe higher resistance. Even assume it is 1 ohm resistance. The single line to ground fault current is reduced to 2 to 30 amps. And hence, in that scenario, your thermal may not be able to pick up your single line to ground fault. So if you want a sensitive earth fault, or if you want to detect the earth fault with a higher resistance, then probably we need to think of dedicated earth fault relay or earth leakage relay. Okay. Now question is, like, in an LV system, means MCBs, MCCBs mostly with a thermal magnetic, and fuse also operates only above their full load current, and hence there is no special care to detect the earth fault at much lower current, less than your full load current. So even if there is an earth fault, you will be able to detect it only above the full load current with the help of MCBs or fuses. So hence, means we are generally using a solid earth systems for this transformer. The same configuration we are using when the grid fails and the diesel generator comes in. So this also we are trying to use the same philosophy, that is, we tend to use solidly grounded diesel generators. This diesel generators allows a single line to ground fault, and if there is any single line to ground fault, that can be detected, right? Why we are not going for a resistance earth systems in the low voltage diesel generators? Even if you go with a small resistor, the single line to ground fault current is limited to a very small value, and hence I mean, your protection devices which are available in an LV systems may not be able to sense that fault. So that's the reason why behind means we are going with the solid earth generators in the low voltage system. Right, let's come to another configuration. Assume there is an industry which receives a power supply at 110 kV and that is stepped down to 11 kV and they have motors and transformer feeders. So assume that if the generator is not there, I'm just keeping it out of service. Okay, so in this case also, I mean here the winding configuration is again delta star, but this star is a resistance circuit. This transformer is resistance circuit on the LV side in order to reduce the single line to ground fault current to say 400 amps or 300 amps. If I am going inside these, so here I mean I have limited the single line to ground fault current to 400 amps, that can be limited to 400 or 300. So the next obvious question comes, why in 11 bar 415 volt transformer here we are just going for a solidly earthed system, correct? Whereas here means in a 110 bar 11 kV we are going with a resistance earthed systems. To answer this question, I mean in a medium voltage, if there are motors, if there is a single line to ground fault within the motor, then there is a higher probability that the motor stator core get damaged. So that's the reason why it is important to limit the single line to ground fault current. And hence when you have 11 kV motors, that means whenever there is a possibility of motors which are connected at 11 kV, it is recommended to go with a resistance earthed system. This resistance NGR limits the single line to ground fault current well below what's the capability of the stator core of the motor ratings. So take a small example where in our house, if we have some small motor, maybe 2 HP motor or 3 HP motor, if the winding blows for whatever may be the reason, because of overload or whatever it is, then we will take this motor to the rewinding shop nearby, and that rewinding shop people itself will be able to rewind this motor and they will be able to give it to us. Hence, what I am trying to say, you need not take this motor back to the original equipment manufacturer. But if your stator core damages or if your stator core gets saturated, then probably your rewinding shop will be able to rewind only the windings but not the stator core itself. And hence, it is difficult and it is time consuming. So hence it is recommended to limit the single line to ground fault current less than the stator core saturation value or damage value. So let's talk about an interesting book. Hope most of you are aware of this book what I am referring to. So this is monograph from the legendary technical guy Dr. K. Rajamani. He has written series of articles and that came as a book, as a monograph. Okay, in that he is talking about an stator earth fault protection for large generators. In that he has given a typical value of the generator core damage curve. Please try to understand this, this is not the stator winding, this is a stator core. Stator windings have a higher short circuit capacity current, but the stator core has a lesser withstand current. So here if you look at this, the current versus time is given, so higher the time it is lesser the current, but generally this is exclusively for a generators. So you can see the current at say example 40 amps, then this generator stator core will withstand only for 2 seconds. Right, so it is essential or important to limit the single line to ground fault current. So this is the point where I am coming to this third one, another connection of the large scale power plants, that is a generator step ups to the nearest substation voltage, that could be 400 or 765 or 220 kV. So then pumps the power to the grid and there is an auxiliary transformer. If you take such a scenario, means this generators are means should be earthed in such a way that the single line to ground fault current in the generator is less than the stator core damage value which is specified here. So we need to check from the various manufacturers, if you are buying a generator, what is the stator core damage curve, something like this. We need to get this value. That curve gives you an idea, I mean, up to what current the single line to ground fault current has to be limited. So in general, for the high capacity generators, we limit the single line to ground fault current to 5 amps. Okay, so means when you are selecting this single line to ground fault current, what's the value to be limited? You need to take the account of the bus duct. Probably you might be having a bus duct here, though I have not drawn it. So that bus duct capacitance, this delta winding capacitance on the low voltage side of the generator step up transformer, and the capacitance of the transformer of auxiliary transformers, that could be a station or unit transformers, delta winding capacitance, and if you have a GCB, generator circuit breaker, that capacitance, everything you have to take, and you have to find out the capacitive current because of that capacitance, and your NGT should be designed in such a way that it limits the current above the capacitive current. So when we are selecting the NGT to limit the single line to ground fault in the large capacity generators, what's the current which you are limiting should be less than the core damage curve, which a sample is given in this care monograph, and it should be higher than the capacitive current induced because of delta winding of the low voltage generator transformer, bus ducts, and even the generator capacitance itself. If it is a GCB, that capacitance, and delta winding of any other auxiliary transformers or unit station transformers which are connected. So you need to find out that capacitive current, and you have to size this NGT and that NGR value, that grounding resistor value, in such a way that the single line to ground fault current is limited higher than the capacitive current. So what's the current which you are limiting in the generator transformer, means generator, should be higher than this capacitive current and lesser than the core damage current. So typically this will be in the range of 5 amps. Okay, but the problem is here, right? When you are running 110 bar 11 kV, we are getting a power supply from grid, and you are running an already local loads in an industry, and in a later phase, if the cogeneration plant comes, already this winding is earthed, that is from an that is a step down transformer from the grid, and even if you go with another resistor here in the generator, but this both the single line to ground faults will be getting cumulatively added, and that fault current will be flowing through this stator core, and we need to check whether that's damaging the stator core or not. So means what to say, for that some special cases which we need to take, and probably there could be some circulating current as well between these two neutrals. So you may either think of adding a unit transformer, or probably means some special precautions to eliminate it. I think I have answered part of the questions. There are some generator configurations which I think I have given, and we have explained why LV generators are solidly earthed. LV generators are solidly earthed because in a low voltage system, molded case circuit breakers, that is MCCB, miniature circuit breakers, fuses, these are all available that may not have a higher sensitive capability to detect the single line to ground fault. And if you are going with an NGR, that is resistance earth resistance, to limit the single line to ground fault current in the low voltage, then these devices may not be able to detect. Hence, we are going with a solidly earthed systems in low voltage, and in a medium voltage, that should be resistance earth resistance, so that single line to ground fault current is limited well below the core damage curve. However, it is designed in such a way that it is higher than the capacitance current which is available. That capacitance is because of your bus duct cable or transformer winding capacitance, everything, right? That is the case with the cogeneration plants and large capacity generators. As I told, this are very critical equipments, and if there is a small single line to ground fault, and if the stator current stator core current exceeds its capability, then the stator core get damaged. Then you have to take that to the original equipment manufacturer. Then probably it takes quite a lot of downtime, and hence means we are using high impedance earthing, which is limiting the single line to ground fault to less than 5 amps in general.